All right, spiritual family. So I'm here to do a quick video because I got a spiritual download that spirit wanted me, source wanted me to share with the spiritual family. I just got this from some Jamaican guy. Daily's Holistic Health Intercellular Cleanser. You know what I'm saying? So let me taste this and see what it do. Shit is wild. Guess you're probably supposed to take like a teaspoonful or a capful. Intercellular cleanser. From Jamaica, organic and natural herbs. Yeah, so health is wealth. So, check this out. Now, we know about this eclipse coming up. You know what I'm saying? And this eclipse got a lot of powerful energy. It's bringing a lot of changes to the planet because what has happened is, again, it's the end of the Caucasian rule on this planet. And like every empire has to come to an end. I mean, we had the Babylonians, Sumerian, Phoenicians, you know, Chemites. These were all Nubian empires that came to an end. You know, then you had the Romans, the Greek. All empires eventually comes to an end. And so this empire that is now come to an end, what this is going to be, the age of Aquarius, like I've said before, power to the people, where the people collectively come together as one, as a human family. We have got to move past, you know, race, ethnicity, and all this other stuff. Because at the end of the day, we are all born here. We are all humans. We are all earthlings. And I got a word for them raggedy assholes over in the Middle East. That, like, I was reading something about one of them, you know, stoning women. They're going to be stoning women again. First of all, you raggedy ass man, women hating men. Did y'all bitches just get out of the caves yesterday dragging on hairy knuckles? Can't speak. Oonga, boonga, boonga. I mean, can you imagine in this day and age, in 2024, stoning women? The women that gives birth to their children. The women that birth those women hating men. Okay, that if it wasn't for women, your society would die, and it is going to die, because you know what? The word that I got from source, because when I read that stuff, I was so troubled within my spirit, and I went into meditation. I got a word, and the word is like, you know, if they start doing that and are doing that, the majority of children that are going to be born are female children, and the men children that are born are going to be severely retarded. And what's going to happen is a lot of the men in that society, in that region, is going to die out rapidly. And they're going to need men from other regions to come in to breed with their women to even keep their culture or whatever it is going. I mean, just imagine how barbaric, I can't even describe the word. Just the idea to think of these men stoning these women to death. And men on this planet have got to realize the mother has rolled up her sleeve to two-piece these men that are not in alignment. And the majority, like about 60 to 70% mother is taken off this planet. We've been got that word. This is why it says in the Bible, in the last days and the patriarchy, there will be several women to one man. Now, why would seven women have to share one man? Because a lot of them is going to be taken off the planet. You know what I'm saying? And then here is some of the fuckery here that I read that, you know, it's just so much fuckery. Let me see here. Let me try to calm myself, because I am not in a good space. This is 12-year-old girl who marries a high priest in Ghana. A 12-year-old girl who was married to a 63-year-old high priest in Ghana has been placed under protection. And the women in this society co-signs this fuckery. Look at this shit. This is a young girl, 12 years old, being married off to this 63-year-old pedophile. I don't care if he's a high priest, pedophile. You know what I'm saying? And the police had to come in and, you know, the legal minimum age to get married is 18. But the West African country has a complex history with harmful tradition. Because, see, people hide behind spirituality. You know what I'm saying? And let me be clear. There is no spirituality that the mother will co-sign of some dusty-ass 63-year-old man marrying a 12-year-old. These are the things that's going on the planet that are going to change. And mother is getting ready to take a whole bunch of people off the planet doing these next level fuckery. Okay, because children should be protected. These groups going in kidnapping children in the continent, you know, the Boko Haram had kidnapped a bunch of girls. They, I don't think all of them was ever returned and all of this stuff. This is why the mother said she is splitting the continent of Africa in half. You understand? And even though scientists, you know, when I said that I got this download, I got a lot of hate mail. You crazy bitch, you bipolar bitch, and this, yeah. Okay, yes, I am motherfucking bipolar, which is bipolar, and I'm not ashamed of it. I'm not here to impress holes on planet Earth and pretend like I'm perfect. I'm honest, I'm ethical, I am just, I am fair, I am loving, kind, compassionate. You understand? But I do have the other side, and yes, which is bipolar, manic depressive, adult ADHD, and psychosis. Okay? And that's just what it is. And I manage that through natural remedies, you know? And so, you know, I manage, you know, the crazies not taking over and jumping out. And these are, you know, some of these are spirits. And I don't mind because they come down through the bloodline and it's up to me to manage them. Okay? And so, the mother has said, you know, she's going to split the continent. And, you know, even though scientists confirmed what I said in a video a few years ago, and they're like, oh, that's not going to happen for a million years or whatever. Yeah, keep fucking that chicken. Now, I may not live to see it in my lifetime, but it's coming. Because the Earth, Mother Earth, who is a living being, she is tired. And one of the things that she has said is that she is no longer going to absorb these toxic, hateful energies that humans keep putting out in her womb. Because like when you have the fuckery going on in so-called Israel with the Israelis, the Palestinians, you know, in Sudan, killing all these people, and you know, the Hutu versus the Tutsis, where 800,000, probably more, Nubians were killed by other Nubians. This fuckery has got to come to an end. And if the mother got to split the continent in half and take half of the people off the continent because of the continued fuckery, well, that's what she's going to do. Because she is actually tired. And then the rest of the fools she's coming for. Because when these people die in this state of hatred and war, their spirits are not at peace. They become in tranquil spirits. And years ago, what I saw was we're going to have to, you know, like them Catholic priests do, go up and down with the censer. You know what I'm saying? Go up and down with the censer in the church and, you know, go over the earth and have these spirits move on, because they can't, and they can attach themselves to people who are weak and make them commit suicide, make them commit murders, all types of stuff. This is real. And this is why so many tragedies happen, because, you know, we have these intranquil spirits running around the earth. Now, they can't run upon somebody like me, but I will feel their energy. You know, this is when, like, you get in an argument with somebody and, you know, you hear that voice that tells you to do some crazy shit, like, oh, just stab them, or just hit them with a chair, or do some fuckery. Or even if you get in a beef outside, or something happens and you're outside in your car and you get that overwhelming urge, oh, just run them over, just hit them with your car. That's not you. That's an intranquil spirit. And this is what is going on, because the mother said she is no longer absorbing these energies in her womb, because what they do is they rot trees. They dry up rivers and lake. Okay? They even can jump in an animal. This is why you see, like, you know, pit bulls that families have raised, and then all of a sudden the pit bull, you know, just attack and maul the child to death, because that was an intranquil spirit just walking by, and it was like, ooh, let me jump into this pit bull. I was murdered, so let me jump into this pit bull, and so this child can be murdered, or this person. This is what happens. This is what happens. And because a lot of people are not on this spiritual path and don't understand the life and death, okay? There is a saying about life and death, but I'm in menopause now, and menopause just be giving you all kind of brain fog, so I can't remember it. But life and death, oh, life and death is in the power of the tongue. I know that one. But life and death are pretty much very similar, because as in life, so in death. And that shit is real. As in life, so in death. If you die a violent death, in death, you're violent. I don't know why people think when you die, you just automatically just go on to the light and float and fly. No, that shit don't happen. This is why we do ancestral work, so that we can elevate our ancestors that died in, whether they died peacefully or violently or, you know, in sickness, because there is unnatural death. Unnatural death is you know, just being stabbed, shot, thrown off of a cliff, mauled by a mountain lion. That's not a natural death. And not everybody is guaranteed, you know, to live till they're 100 and their family surrounds them and hold their hands and, you know, it was great while it was being here. Peace out, bitches. I'm leaving. No. A natural death is getting, you know, like you dying of a heart attack at 16 or even at 50. Unnatural death, unnatural sickness are like cancer, dying of cancer, dying of like some terminal illness. These are also spirits that inhibit, okay, the body. Now, let me do this ritual, and I'm going to take my black ass on, because I'm not doing a long video. Now, when I was meditating, the ritual that I got is to be done on this eclipse, because this eclipse is going to be done in Aries. Just hold on 1 second. I'll be back. All right. I'm back. So, and I have some notes here. First of all, let me just say something with this eclipse. It's actually a rebirth. It's a rebirth. It's like humanity is getting a do-over. This is why it's in Aries. Aries is the first house. The first house is all about rebirth. New beginnings. Okay, it's new beginnings. The old has been wiped away and the new is coming. Now, the new is going to take time to manifest, but when I tell you, stuff on this planet has changed. Because I just, every day I go out and I drive and I look and I'm like, wow, this stuff has really, really changed. Now, it's still looks the same, but the frequency is different. And like, wow, we are truly in a different time where a lot of stuff is going to change. Justice, first of all, this is Saturn's reign, the return of Saturn's reign. Okay? And let me just go here and read some stuff about Saturn, the crone mother Saturn. Let me see. We're actually in the hour of Mars. Well, let me read about Mars. Will, courage, combat, energy. You know what I'm saying? The hell is this? The fuck is this on my phone? Okay, skip this bitch. Okay. Okay. This is all about challenges, overcoming obstacles. However, Mars is fiery, and there's a need to watch about accidents. You know what I'm saying? So I would not encourage anybody to go out to any place that where there's going to be large amounts of people, you know, like out to a park or a festival or anything, because there are some people, if they cannot handle this eclipse energy, it might trigger psychosis in them, you know. And you never know what mass shooters is around, that some spirit is going to jump into their ass to go shoot up the place, okay? But Saturn is all about discipline, patience, overcoming obstacle, repairing that which is broken, hard work, responsibility, ancestors, age, maturity, hierarchy, foundation, structure, administration. Okay? Command, stability, slavery, caution, honor, duty, law, restriction. I'm doing a video. Pragmatism, prudent, punctuality, obligation, and principle. You coming with your shirt off? Are you trying to come on my video with your shirt off?
No, that's why I have on my hoodie.
Okay, Negro,
Yeah.
please. Okay?
I don't want your video to expose my color views and.
Oh, please, yes, come with your shirt off. Come.
Nah.
Yeah, come.
Nah.
God, you're so.
What's up?
Yes, my son Amun Ra.
I'm about to go to
My favorite child.
yeah, I'm about to go to you
Him and Heru.
I'm about to go to ULove Wings. That's really why I was calling you, because you was really
Yeah,
cute.
well, we can go up there, but let me just finish this video because I'm doing a quick ass video. And then I'm gonna go sit in the sun.
Wait, are you coming with me to go?
I can,
Are you
yes.
gonna get something?
No, I don't want anything, but I'm coming. All right, let me just wrap this up. Okay, and so, you know, this eclipse is a do-over. This is like we get an opportunity to get it right as humanity, okay? And we have to let the past go. This is all about forgiveness, okay? The past, first of all, the past is in the past. Whatever happened yesterday, you can't press a button and go back there. This is why I stopped doing Akashic Record readings. And I mean, you know, Akashic Record readings, if you want to know what you were in a past life. But like I said, I've read for brothers and sisters that were kings and queen in this life. You sell and ask for a place to stay. How does that help you? You're homeless in this life. How does that help you? It really can't. Focus on this life so this life can be the best life, that your next life can be even better. You understand? Because maybe when you were kings and queens, you were very selfish. You know, you were not kind. And so you are here to experience what it is like, you know, not having. Okay, so now, let me tell you the ritual that source gave me. Get some ancestral banknotes. This one is like, I think, $1 million banknotes. This is a ritual I got when I was meditating. Get some banknote. And what you are going to write on here, oh, let me see my notes. Because I did put them in my phone when I got these down. I got this download. And I'm like, oh, shit. I got to make sure I write this down. Ritual. This is a ritual for breaking generational curses. On a $10 million ancestral banknote, right, I, so-and-so, remove all ancestral and generational curses from my bloodline, my matrilineal and my patrilineal. I, so-and-so, paid this debt in full and ask a source, and I also invoke Anubis and my Aat to wipe the generational curses clean and restore order to my bloodline. And then you can, you know, if you want to write on it, I break the general curses, or I revoke incest, alcoholism, drug abuse, mental illness, poverty, abandonment. Because people have had people in their bloodline who have abandoned, like your mother may have left, or your father left, you know what I'm saying? And there's still a hole in the heart. We revoke and remove and break general curses of witchcraft that was thrown on the bloodline from people in the bloodline. You'll be surprised. Family members got some fucked up family members. I know I got one, and she did some shit, and I was gonna run down on her and give her these hands. And I always had like this image of like 10 ancestors running across a football field to tackle me, because they're like, oh shit, she getting ready to do some real damage, you know. And I guess this person, I was not supposed to give them the hands, you know. But it was like, yo, you family and you close family and you do some fuck shit like that? Nah, man, I gotta give you these hands. And the ancestors did not want me to. They was just like, you know, they'll reap what they have sown. So I just step back. But again, this is the ritual to be done on the eclipse. Write it down. You know, that I so-and-so, okay, revoke, break, remove generational curses from the bloodline. I remove and break and revoke all ancestral generational curses from my bloodline. I pay this debt in full, and I invoke Anubis and my Aat to wipe the curses clean and to restore order to the bloodline. And then what I was given is you take some fruit or flowers along with some wine to a tree for offering. And after you do that, you are going to take a lighter, and you're going to light it. And you can go by a tree, or if you're, you know, well, you should be outside, light it and let it go up into the ether. But you're going to speak it, because where we are now in the age of magic, okay, is to speak things into existence. And this is some other one, hell banknote. This is $10,000. I'm going to use one for $1 million. You know what I'm saying? But whatever. I'm not feeling $10,000 is going to be enough, you know. I'm feeling like the $1 million, you know. Yeah, because I have a bunch of the hell notes, and these are some $10,000 ones. And let's see. These are the other ones with the $1 million, okay, because I buy these in bulk. And you know, ancestral ritual to remove poverty from the bloodline, you know, so that your businesses and everything can be successful. So again, what you are going to do is to write on here that you revoke and you break all generational curses, all ancestral bloodline curses. You know, you are going to, you know, break generational curses. Anything that you want in the bloodline, like I said, poverty, abandonment, mental illness, homelessness, you know, incest, you break all of that, you know, and remove, you also break and remove the traumas of slavery, because the traumas of slavery are very real. They are still affecting people who cannot move on from that. You know what I'm saying? And so some people need to break, you know, because you might have an ancestor that got hung in slavery. Somebody that when we were sold to the Europeans by our lovely brothers and sisters on the continent who went around conquering tribes and sold Jamaicans to the British, you know, and Trinidadians, Haitians, you know, that's how we ended up in the islands. We were sold by our own brothers and sisters. And so, you know, I don't hold any grudges against that because that's what it is. You understand? And so, but we had ancestors that had to jump, that jumped over the ship, that more than likely jumped in some shark-infested water. You know what I'm saying? When people die under those conditions, when people die in slavery, there's a lot of rage and anger and stuff that comes down the bloodline, which is why some of us have so much trauma today, you know, like with people going to prison, committing murder, going to prison, you know what I'm saying? Because they could be having just a simple ass argument with somebody and then they have some ancestor jump into them and like kill them, murder them, you know, and they listen to that voice and they do it. Or there is an intranquil spirit. And, you know, this is why we do spiritual work to fortify and protect our bodies. So we can't have anything jumping in. Because it's a lot of people that get possessed. You know what I'm saying? And you got to make sure that you cannot have those. Because they roll up. They roll up. I hear them. They'll roll up. And will say some shit. And I'm like, get the fuck out of here. I'm not doing that. You know what I'm saying? But they can't jump into me and make me do some shit because my temple is protected. Okay? And I'll probably do another video on, I'll do another video on that and protecting your temples. But, and for some reason, after I got that download on doing that, they told me about some cloves. And they wanted, you know, folks to get some cloves and put it by a tree. And I know cloves in witchcraft. Let me eat a couple of cloves. These are also good for you. In witchcraft, these are all about prosperity. Huh?
What are those? Let me see.
Oh, these are cloves.
Oh, it is.
Cloves. You can just eat a couple of them. I mean, they ain't the most pleasant things. But
are you supposed to be eating this?
Yeah, it does good things for the body. But in witchcraft, it can be about protection and it can be about prosperity. So let's just say, you know, you write your things on that and you can put a couple of cloves, or when you burn it and it goes into the ether or whatever, you throw up some cloves in the air or put it by a tree. So this was the ritual that I was given to share with the collective, because this eclipse is literally a do-over. It's new beginnings for us as a human family to come together in love, in balance. Cloves are nasty.
I know. Pretty sure you're not supposed to.
Shit tastes like the crack of Satan's ass. We got any water? Hold on, I'm gonna get some water. Ah, these cloves are just not nice. Where are you getting the water from?
I don't know.
I got water upstairs in my room. Oh. Yeah, in my closet. That's okay. So, you know, again, take these notes, because what you're going to do is to pay this debt. You are the one that was chosen by the ancestors to do this work, because obviously it is your ass that's running across these videos. And so being that you're running across these videos, you know what I'm saying? You are expected to do this work. And so this is the ritual, okay? So remember, I, so-and-so, I, priestess Aset, you know, pay this debt in full to remove all ancestral and generational bloodline curses. I ask the source and I invoke Anubis and Maat to wipe all curses from my bloodline clean and to restore order to the bloodline. I, so-and-so, revoke all generational curses, all bloodline curses, and you outline whatever. You understand? Just think of the things that people have been through. You know, murder. You know, somebody might have been murdered. Somebody might have committed suicide. Somebody might have abandoned their children. You know, somebody might have been raped. Somebody might have been homeless, might have had their land stolen from them, you know, whatever. And you put whatever. And when you are finished, you don't have to anoint with any oils unless you want to, you know, because I'm tapping into source right now. Unless you want to anoint with some oils, you can if you want to put like rosemary oil or, you know, any kind of oil. Okay, and then you light it and you can let it, you know, put it by a tree. Because there's something about trees that they are divinely connected to the spirit realm. They're connected to the earth realm, the air realm, and all. And spirit and trees got spirits in them. So you can do this by a tree, or if you don't have access to a tree and you're outside, you can let the embers go into the ether, because when it goes into the ether, it is heard. And then you can throw up some cloves. I don't know, they gave me cloves at the last minute, you know. And so cloves have a lot of stuff. If you want to, you can Google, like, let's Google the spiritual purpose of cloves. S-P-I-R-I, spiritual purpose, P-U-R P-O-S-E, off cloves, C-L-O-V-E-S. Six spiritual benefits of clove is known to be powerful in cleansing, okay? Dispel negativity, okay? Remove pain in our lives, as well as to open us up for love and friendships. You know what I'm saying? So for those of you, clove spiritual benefits, they're very magical, you know, and they have, you know, all about success, you know, friendship, healing, protection, prosperity, you know, they have a bunch of meanings. You know what I'm saying? And so, you know, this is what you want to incorporate. I would even like, this is just me, like you're rolling a spliff. I don't smoke weed because it don't do nothing good for me. Makes me want to kill people. So being that my black ass know that, I stay away from that. You can even put some cloves in there and you can squeeze it, and you can, after you write your stuff, this is what I'm seeing, this is a ritual that's coming to me right now, as you you've already written your stuff in it, and you've already oiled it if you want to, and you know, and you roll it up. Amun-Ra, get me a lighter, please.
A lighter, please.
And give me this thing here that I burn incense in. Give me this thing here that I burn incense in. And so, let's see. Yeah, you do that. Hold this for me. You do that, and
I'm hungry.
Yeah, calm your tits. Soon get something. And you burn it, and let's see.
Can't touch your fingers.
Gimme. And you burn it, the cloves is coming. And it's something here with the cloves being burnt. Yes. And yeah, that's the ritual right there. That's it right there. That's the ritual. That's the ritual with it right there they wanted me to get. And then, yes, you put it by a tree. Okay, family? So that's the ritual. You know what I'm saying? That's the exact ritual it is. Because first they gave me just the ancestral money and writing the stuff down. Mm. And it smells, as the Germans would say, wunderbar. It smells wonderful. Okay? And so, yeah, this is what it is. You know, you put the cloves in it after you've written down, you know, where you're breaking all the generational curses. You know what I'm saying? And if you don't know all the generational curses, you can say, I so-and-so revoke and break all generational curses in my bloodline, known and unknown. Because the unknown, if you don't know it, but being that you're speaking it out, all unknown, then whatever is unknown must be broken. And you put the clove and you like you're rolling a spliff. And when you light it, you know what I'm saying? Then you let it just go. And so that's the ritual right there. So on that note, spiritual family, I'm taking my black ass on. My son want to go get some wingdings and stuff. But this was the ritual that I was given to share with you that you are to do on the day of the eclipse, okay? Because this is a new beginning. This is starting over. This is a renewal. And this is a starting over for humanity, for us as a family. We have got to move past race, creed, sexuality, gender, all that stuff. Yes, there's the divine feminine and the divine masculine. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, we are a human family. We were all born here. And we all have got to come together. You understand? Because now is the age of Aquarius, which is a return of Saturn's reign. And it's all about justice and karma. And it's about to be on and popping. The old system and empire, little infant empire, is done. It has passed away. Now, we're not going to see changes overnight, but the changes are in the process, and it's done. And no matter what they do, they cannot stop anything. Because I've even heard these crazy bitches was firing rockets at the eclipse. Really, bitches? You know what I'm saying? You cannot stop anything. I mean, just think of how brilliant the sun is, billions of miles away from the earth. And you think your little rockets can do something? Fuck around and find out. So, on that note, until next time, same bat time, same bat channel, all right? All right.